Welcome to Hudson Hockey on the River Channel. I'm Chris Larson. Later on, Paul Pruitt will be joining us. He's running a little bit late to John Gornick Memorial Arena tonight. But tonight, our competition comes from just up the road. It's Somerset coming down here to play the Hudson Raiders. Somerset starting for them tonight. We've got sophomore Aaron Moore, senior Jesse Anderson, senior Derek Tarter, senior Bryce Wold, and between the pipes for Somerset, junior Jordan Langness. For the Raiders tonight, starting the senior Matt Stracoda between the pipes. In the defense spots, we've got Daniel Trapiccio, the junior, Josh Dardine, the senior, and then up front, we've got James Fall, a senior, Lawrence Pruitt, the senior, and Dylan Haskins, a senior. This Somerset team is a pretty darn good hockey team. They come into tonight's game 10-5, and they should be a pretty good challenge for our Raiders, who come into the game tonight 7-6. Somerset has played River Falls twice, beat them twice. That's a common opponent for the Raiders. Raiders played them once and defeated them 3-2. They've also played Menominee and lost to them both times. Raiders a winner. We're going to pause for our national anthem. So the Raiders about ready to tip it off here with Somerset. And Somerset, a team that we could see in the postseason. We're in the same bracket with Somerset and some of the other teams. A lot of the Big River schools that you traditionally think of as Raider opponents in the playoffs in the other bracket. So many of those Big Rivers teams that we see throughout the season are in a different bracket. So we're about ready to get going here. One thing to note. The Spartans do not start Adam Marty, who is a sophomore. He's their high scorer with 14 goals in the season and 9 assists. So he's a second-line player that is sure to capture our attention. So it'll be fun watching him tonight. But, of course, the Raiders play pretty deep as well. So we haven't seen much of Matt Stracoda. Most of his starts this season have been on the road. I believe we've only got one game with him so far, and that was at River Falls. So get to see Matt Stracoda. Usually when the River Channel is covering these games at home, we see Josh Mattis, the junior. So it'll be fun to see Stracoda, the senior, between the pipes tonight as well. Stracoda coming off an all-conference season as a defensive lineman for the Raider football team. Here's James Fall. Gets the puck from Haskins. Now Haskins in the corner. Fall looking for somebody up front. Pruitt there waiting for him. Here's Fall still looking. Gets it to Pruitt. Pruitt can't get it to go, and they get tangled up there behind the net. Here's Fall once again with the puck. Raiders controlling here in the Somerset zone. Here's Haskins. Kicks it back to the corner to Pruitt. And now Pruitt looking for Fall. Couldn't get it to go, and now Somerset will control. Josh Dardine sends it back into the Somerset zone. Fall controlling. Trapiccio was looking for the puck, couldn't get it. And now Pruitt into the corner with Haskins. Here's Fall, and now Trapiccio is going to send it over to Dardine. And Somerset able to get control as the Raiders switch out some personnel. Henry Burrows enters the game along with Mike Holmes. Here's Bros. Sends the puck forward. Holmes tries to stop it. Dardine still in there on defense. And here's David Kane. Kane wearing number 18, Bros 17. Gets it out front to Mike Holmes, but Holmes can't catch up to it. Holmes still with the puck. Kicks it over to Berkey. Berkey sends it towards the net, but it hits the back, and we will have a faceoff. Mike Holmes playing in just his second game after returning from a broken jaw. Held him out of probably five or six games. He was out for, I don't know, maybe 3 weeks or so. Holmes donning the same number 10 he wears on the football field. And here's A.J. Romanowski, who sends the puck to the back. Henry Bros battling for it back there. And the puck's going to go into the Raider zone. Stephen Berkey kicks it over Romanowski. Romanowski looking for Ben Lewis. Ben Lewis can't quite get there. And Dylan Haskins down there battling it out. Kicks it over to Berkey. And here's August Newton, number 15 in the corner. Now Ben Lewis controlling. Back to Newton. Here's Newton. Oh, can't keep control. And now Dylan Haskins takes it. Romanowski. And we've lost the puck in the rafters. Romanowski fired it toward the net, hit a Somerset player, and the puck went into the sky and never came back down. So we'll have another faceoff here. Taylor Casey will stand in there for the Raiders. Emerson Corum wearing 19 right in front of us here. The defenseman behind him will be Daniel Trapiccio and number 4, Jake Quadi, hanging out right there. Raiders looking to get back into the win column after losing Saturday to Superior. Not much shame in that. Superior was number 4 in the state when they played the game there. Now Somerset getting something going here. Somerset, of course, in the road red sweaters. Raiders in the home whites with blue trim. Matt Strakota covering it up down there. Starting to get a little chippy down there. These guys know each other well. Just down the road, Somerset and Hudson, only about 8-10 miles apart. Guys who probably played each other for many years coming up through the ranks. Oh, Somerset had a nice opportunity there. It was Reed Kelly with the puck for Somerset. Firing it that way again. Here's Daniel Trapiccio controlling in the corner. Looking for somebody to get it out to. Trapiccio still handling the puck. Greg Berg out in front of him. And nobody there for the rebound. Oh, there's James Fall. Fall looking for someone. He'll fire it himself. Tries to go top shelf. Went too high. And the Raiders switching out some personnel. Here comes Lawrence Pruitt into the game along with Dylan Haskins. Dardine's going to control the puck as Somerset switches out there, men. Berkey looking to fire it forward, kind of whiffed. There's Dardine, sends it to the back line. Dardine once again controlling there for the Raiders. And Somerset will send it into the Raiders zone. It was Drew Kelly for the Spartans. Here's Haskins now with the puck for the Raiders. Sends it over to Berkey. Berkey back to Haskins. Haskins forward to Pruitt. Pruitt gets around a player. Sends it up front for Haskins. Haskins puts it in the net. Just like that, the Raiders take a 1-0 lead. 4.5 minutes into the contest, Pruitt with a pretty pass out front for Haskins, and Haskins makes it count. Raiders leading 1-0 early on in this contest, and We've seen them at home kind of fall behind early. This is one of the first times that we've seen the Raiders take a lead. They seem to be a third period team. They can get a goal early. They're going to be dangerous once we get to the third period. Got an icing call there on Somerset. That was Dylan Haskins' 15th goal of the season for Lawrence Pruitt. That's his 9th assist of the year. David Kane settles in here to take the faceoff for the Raiders. Somerset able to control. And Holmes had a chance to steal it. Strakota kicking it over to the corner. Holmes gets it to Kane. Kane loses control, but Henry Bros right there. Bros sends it to the back line. No icing. Mike Holmes behind the net. Here comes James Fall. Holmes sends a bouncer to Fall. Quadi tried to control. Here comes Romanowski, the sophomore. Romanowski over to Ben Lewis. James Fall now controlling the puck for the Raiders. Sends it towards goal, and he'll cover it up. Jordan Langness, the goaltender for the Spartans. Langness has pretty much logged all the minutes for Somerset between the pipes this year. He comes in with a 2.35 goals against average, 91% save percentage, so pretty solid season for Langness. Fall took the faceoff. Newton steals the puck away. Fall fighting for it. Here's Ben Lewis. Ben Lewis puts it out front. Now it's behind the net. Ben Lewis tries the backhander, but can't get it to go. The puck hung up in Lagnus's skates, I believe. Lewis with a couple nice opportunities there for the Raiders. Raiders with 4 shots on goal tonight. Somerset has yet to put one on net. Taylor Casey takes the faceoff for Hudson. And here's Casey once again. He loses it. Somerset with the breakaway. Dardine's there with Romanowski to break that one up. Dardine looked for Greg Berg, couldn't get there. Now the puck back into the Raiders' zone. Romanowski to Emerson Corum. And here's Taylor Casey, gets it to Berg. Berg with a little run here, leaves it for Casey. Trapiccio sends it towards the goal. It gets hung up in the net. So we'll face it off again. The Raiders sending their first line back into the game. Pruitt, Fall, Haskins, Berkey, and Romanowski. Haskins fires it up against the glass. Pruitt gets the puck, sends it towards the net. Glove save for Langness. And that'll set us up again down here in the zone. We'll do it on the near side. Haskins once again in there for the Raiders. Pruitt to his left, Fall to his right. Somerset controls. There's Berkey with the puck. Somerset looking to get it out of their zone, but Haskins breaks it up, gets it over to Fall. Fall can't control, and now Pruitt will go over there. Haskins trying to steal it away. He does. Now Fall tries to get it to Haskins. Out front there for Pruitt. Pruitt bounces off of Langness. James Fall looking to make something happen. He's got Pruitt there with him but can't get it to him. Haskins tried to leave it out there for Berkey, and Alex Meekey able to steal it away for Somerset. Romanowski now with the puck. He'll send it up against the glass. And now Haskins controlling for the Raiders. Gets it over to Pruitt. Pruitt slows it up, lets everything clear out. Somerset makes a few substitutions. Pruitt sends it to the back wall. Bros in there fighting for the puck, along with David Kane, number 18. And here's Bros. Couldn't hold on to it. Now Mike Holmes. He sends it around. Bros back the other way. Mike Holmes, number 10 there to try to stop the forward action here. Bros looking to send it up front. Jake Quadi bounces it around again. David Kane with the puck, sends it out front but can't get there. Somerset working hard to clear the zone, and they do. Here's Quadi. Bounces it off the boards. Stracota kicks it to Quadi. Quadi back to Trapiccio. Quadi leaves it out there for Holmes, but he can't get there. Now Ben Lewis, number 12, controlling for Hudson. He sends it to the back line. August Newton in number 15. Here's Pruitt. Somerset tries to put a shot up there, but Trapiccio blocks it with his leg. And now Ben Lewis kicks it ahead, looking for August Newton. Shot there by Stephen Berkey. Berkey's not afraid to let it fly from the blue line. Pruitt looking to get the puck, puts a nice check on the Somerset player. Still battling for the puck. Now Taylor Casey has it. Fighting it out over there on the boards. Get it to Emerson Corum. Corum looking to make something happen here. Leaves it out for Casey. Nobody else coming, though. Here's Greg Berg, number 5. And the puck will go to Casey. Romanowski back to Berg. Berg controlling. Trapiccio put on the ground, and now Somerset with an opportunity here. But Corum's able to steal it away. James Fall trying to make something happen. Couldn't get going. Gets it over to Trapiccio. Trapiccio ahead looking for Fall. And we'll have an icing call, and that should bring some substitutions. .528 left in this first period. Raiders leading it 1-0 over Somerset. So Haskins now back in there for the Raiders. He'll take the faceoff, and he gets to Trapiccio. Daniel Trapiccio, the junior, sends it over to Pruitt. And we've got a call. Looks like it's going to be on Josh Dardine of the Raiders. This is our first penalty of the night. Somerset. Somerset will go into the power play here. Got a check from behind on Josh Dardeen. And, of course, we've got a much more emphasis on that call after what happened over in Minnesota about a month ago. And seeing a lot more of the check from behind calls. That's a good thing. So the penalty on Dardeen, but Emerson Corum will serve it for the Raiders. So you may see Dardeen on the ice. So the Raiders skating shorthanded now. Here's James Fall. Raiders have put a few goals in the net shorthanded this season. Somerset looking for their first real opportunity this game. They've got no shots on goal so far in this period. And here's one for him. Had an opportunity there. That's Zachary Dibadal for Somerset. Strakota with a nice save. Dibadal with 10 goals in the season for the Spartans. Couldn't get it to go there, though. Haskins sends the puck all the way back to the goal. Spartans will switch out some personnel. Raiders will as well. And Strakota sends the puck away. Still battling it out down there. Puck out front. Somerset couldn't get anything to happen. Now they'll send the puck towards Strakota. Somerset still looking for some opportunities out there. 13 seconds left in the power play for the Spartans. They've had a couple shot opportunities. This time, Strakota just steps on it. We'll have a face-off. And look who the cat dragged in. Mr. Pruitt arrives. You missed some great action. Your son with a nice assist early in this game.
You know, I tell you, coming in from the office, I got a little bit delayed, and just my luck, I missed it. But, yeah, the Raiders are bringing it together, and Matt's in the net tonight.
That's right. We haven't seen a whole lot of Strakota this season. He's been starting a lot of games, but most of them on the road. Mattis has been the home starter for the most part.
It's good to be here. Nice frosty night for it.
Ooh! Trapiccio blocks it with his body. And now the Raiders back to full strength. Strakota making the stop once again. 3:16 left in the period. Both teams back to full strength. And the Raiders still defending that 1-0 lead. Pruitt in there on the faceoff. Tries to get it ahead for Newtman. And here's Ben Lewis controlling. Sit out over there. Dibadal once again with the shot for the Spartans. Strakota holding serve. Dibadal will let it fire again, and now
kicks the net, comes off.
Loose.
Boy, Matt, an outstanding athlete on so many levels, a fantastic football player, and been kind of weeding in the new blood for Hudson Raider hockey here this year as he kind of traded time in the net this season with Josh, who's done a really good job as well.
Strakota comes in the game with just a 2.32 goals against average. He's played some nice hockey this season. Nice block there by Emerson Corum. Lays down. Doesn't allow the puck to get the net. There's Berg. Gets it to Fall.
Fall fires one off. Look at that.
Taylor Casey now. Romanowski sends the puck to Corum. And now Fall once again with the puck for the Raiders.
And here he comes through the neutral zone, all by himself, surrounded by Spartans.
And now Somerset controlling. They'll send the puck towards Strakota. Comes loose, but bounces the right way for the Raiders.
Trapiccio bringing it around, looking for somebody to kick it up to, and he does.
Bryce Wold controlling there for Somerset. Send it over to Dylan Haskins.
Ooh.
Jake Quade just leveled a player over there.
Crowd goes wild for that one. And Haskins around the back looking to set something up. So Hudson.
Here's Pruitt. Pruitt leaves it out there. Bros couldn't get it to go. Another nice pass by Pruitt.
We're winding down the first period here.
40 seconds left. Somerset looking to get something going here. And now Romanowski kicks it over to Berkey. Berkey back over towards Romanowski. Mike Holmes looking to take control of the puck. And we got a delayed call here. So we'll have a face-off in the Somerset zone with just 10 seconds left in the period. Haskins in there for the Raiders. Somerset controls the puck, but Berkey breaks it up. Now Romanowski. Strakota sends the puck over to the boards. And that's going to be your period. So at the end of one, the Raiders lead it 1-0. And really in the early goings of this game, Somerset had no chance. And, Paul, you just kind of walked in there towards the end. But, you know, Somerset had that power play, and that's where they got their shots on goal. And until they had that power play, they really were – very, very much dominated by the Raiders. This game closer on the scoreboard than it's actually been played.
Raiders looking for a victory after last week's game with up shorter than they'd like.
Fell to Superior over the weekend 5-1, but things going in the right direction for them here. So Paul and I will be right back with the second period. Second period about to get underway. The Raiders holding on to a 1-0 lead, looking to stretch it out here in the second period against Somerset. Dylan Haskins will take the faceoff for Hudson. Paul Pruitt promises to be here for the entire period this time.
Yeah, I know I'll have to take the nice sketch you put together for what happened before I got here. Sure is a nice thing you do, Chris, with all these games on tape. I know the guys are pretty psyched about watching it later, and say hello to the folks in Atlanta that get a chance to watch this. All my sisters down there.
Pretty good crowd here. Finals going on at the high school right now, so a lot of kids at home studying.
Or so the Germans would have you believe. And here comes Pruitt. Oh, and he gets set on his booty. Oh, James takes a little board banger.
Boy, it looks like the Spartans have come out in this period looking to put a hurting on some folks. Every time the Raiders have touched the puck, Somerset's leveled the man who gets the pucks. Come out here with renewed vigor in
That's
the second
a fact.
Period. Here's Haskins over to Berkey.
Dylan to Berkey. Berkey in the neutral zone, kicks it over to the boards. James Fall getting in the goalie's
Langus
business
there.
Nice.
Himself.
Oh!
Looking for Holmes. Then Kane tried to send it towards the net. Wang has found himself astray from the goal there for a moment.
And here come the Spartans. Hudson breaks it up quick. Trapiccio kicking it away.
Waddy with the puck, gets it over to Henry Burrows.
Oh, and it high stick on the Spartans there, looks like.
And that stops the breakaway. Not only does it put a man in the box, but really they had a great opportunity there for a breakaway shot, and they lose that opportunity as well.
And to the Spartan side we go. And he's going to look for some more action. Two Spartans, two on three.
Now I believe we got an offsides call. Brings the puck back into the neutral zone. David Kane will take the faceoff for Hudson. Send the puck out front, but Mike Holmes able to control it. Kicks it over to Trapiccio. And
the goalie picks it up.
Langness takes control for Somerset. We're a minute 41 into the second period. Raiders still leading 1-0 over Somerset. Raiders in the white and blue. Somerset in the red and black. James Fall will take the faceoff for Hudson. Reed Kelly for Somerset. Fall from his knees, couldn't get it to go.
And Berkey misses the pass, but
Shirkota leaves it for Berkey. And Romanowski and now Berkey. Berkey ahead to Ben Lewis.
Ben Lewis trying to scrap it out. Here comes James Fall. Boy, James sure is coming to his own this season. Great to see him having a fantastic season as a forward. Number two on the scoring list.
6 goals, 14 assists for James Fall this season.
Generous player.
Raiders will switch out personnel. Henry Berg, Emerson Corum coming in.
Oh, swing and a miss.
Berkey sent it flying again as well. Berg looking to go up front, nobody home. Berg breaks it up. Sends it out to Corum. And now Berg handling. Back to Corum. Drive it all. And they had a great opportunity there and missed the puck.
And Taylor Casey can't quite keep up with it. Berg got it against the wall. All by himself, and a Spartan steals it. And here come the Spartans. Fires one off of Matt's elbow.
Zach Drybidol, he's having a nice game for Somerset. Spartans haven't been able to score a goal, but Drybidol's been in there in a lot of their opportunities.
Pruitt mugging a guy on the boards. Here comes Pruitt looking for somebody, kicks it up, Fall there, but nothing.
Wow. Romanowski, or Quadi, takes a shot down there.
Haskins getting a break there as he falls. And Pruitt all by himself with two guys on him. He's looking to try to make something happen.
Bounce it against the boards. Now Fall sends the puck back around. Pruitt battling for it with Haskins. Comes Alex.
Jake Quadi tangling him up pretty good there. Matt stops it. Oh, it's still in play. and the icing call. I didn't think anybody knew was waiting for a whistle that never came.
Somerset thought Strakota sat down on it, but he just bounced it off and sent it over to his defenseman.
Well, nice crowd on hand tonight for finals night.
The Bananas here.
Yes.
You know it's a big game when the Banana shows up.
And off the glass. Stephen Berkey in the neutral zone. Kicks it over into the Spartan territory. And up against the boards, Henry Bros.
Romanowski broke up what would have been a nice breakaway for Somerset. Here they come again. This time Bros breaks it up.
Fires one and Matt catches it.
Nice glove save there by Strakota. That'll set up a face-off. Both teams will switch out personnel here. And they'll call interference on Romanowski. Second penalty of the night for Hudson. Somerset has yet to go to the sin bin.
Dylan Haskins at the faceoff in the Hudson zone. To the points, the Spartans trying to make something happen. Off the stick. James Fall, he is really getting after it tonight. Here comes James, passes it up to Dylan Haskins through the neutral zone, fires it back to Fall, and it looks like we got a, and he gets one just for his own. And the net's off, or? That looked awful pretty till it didn't count.
Just wanted to prove a point, I guess.
So is that an offside, Chris?
Well, that looks like to be the call, but. Offsides call. Somerset looking for a penalty there because Fall did send the puck into the net well after the whistle, but they won't get it.
Well, he was just that focused, Chris.
Play through the whistle.
Oh, Pruitt tangled up with two Spartans.
Somerset had some nice opportunities the last time they were on the power play.
Minute 30 on their power play now.
The Raiders have really outskated them throughout much of this game, but in that power play, Somerset had some chances. Pruitt bounces it out for Trapiccio.
Trapiccio getting a little close to the ref, and he digs it out. And here come the Spartans. Oh, intercepted by Trapiccio, who's making his way through the neutral zone. Looking for somebody out front, Kane.
Now Pruitt with the puck for the Raiders.
Kicks it back to Berkey. Here comes Trapiccio. Matt's pulling in his goalie here.
Raiders putting another skater on the ice.
What the hell happened there, Chris?
Well.
Matt had to go to the bathroom really bad, and sometimes, got a slashing call, looks like, on the.
It's a non-conference game, so sometimes you take a few shots and just kind of see what happens. And really, the Somerset team is a team we could see in the postseason, so we're in the same bracket with them. Kind of try a few things out here.
Wow. So for the extra skater, you run the risk of the empty net. And to the points they go. Trapiccio fires right into the belly button. Another Spartan goalie.
Yeah, I don't know if you do that against a team that is skating with you, but really, tonight the Raiders have controlled the puck for most of the evening. So maybe they figured put an extra skater in there and they'd keep control of the puck, keep it over in the Somerset zone.
Playing the odds, money puck. And Trapiccio looking to set it up. Oh, and he gets tangled up.
Both teams skating 4-on-4 here. And 20 Trapiccio. Seconds left before the Raiders will have an advantage.
And Somerset here comes the Spartans.
With the 2-on-1
fires it off of Matt's pad.
Drew Kelly the senior for Somerset. Here's Mike
Holmes. Deacon his way through, and everybody's sliding.
Gets it out front to Berkey.
Oh, Berkey's keeping it in there.
Raiders at full strength.
And Pruitt comes out and grabs it.
Raiders will have about a minute of advantage here. 106 left in their power play.
Taylor Casey kicking it back into the corner. James Fall on it. Pruitt tangling, looking to dig one out. Takes a knee. Fall's got it now. Here he comes. Around the corner looking for somebody up front. AJ's there. Oh!
Couldn't get it to go, and now the puck will go all the way back to Strakota. And he'll kick it ahead for Mike Holmes, or actually Lawrence Pruitt.
Here comes Pruitt. Dylan right across the front. Oh, and
it's nice AJ. Thinking there. Pruitt figured he just passed by knocking it off the goalie.
James Fall with a puck, kicks it back. Here comes Haskins. Through the middle he goes. Nobody there. Hard to keep up with it.
Leaves it for Fall.
Here comes Fall, looking to slap one just outside.
5 seconds left in the power play. And we've got another whistle. So it looks to be on Somerset as well.
2 minutes for hooking on the Spartan forward.
Jesse Anderson, the senior, will go to the penalty box for another 2 minutes. Raiders will have 2 seconds of 5-on-3 skating, and then they'll have another minute 58 of 5-on-4. Raiders have been very good at scoring at the tail end of power plays.
David Kane at the faceoff now. He kicks it back. Firing away is AJ. Kicking it to Trapiccio. Kicks one right in and off the pad of the Spartan goalie.
5-on-4 now for the next minute 50 for the Raiders.
Yeah, they want this.
Kane over to Holmes. Now to Bros. Looking to break it up is Kane.
Kane's got it off of Bros' back. Ooh, sandwich move.
Now Bros sends it to the back.
Oh!
Holmes, who left it out there for Bros, and he couldn't get it to go.
David Kane pops it up, hand pass, and oh, everybody's getting a piece of it. And the Spartans finally get into the Hudson zone. Oh, empty. James Fall in the back. He's got possession. He tries to squirt one in. AJ's on it. Oh, and he fires another.
Fall back again. Couldn't get it to go.
And here come the Spartans. Trapiccio in the corner, bringing it out. And he's going to bring it through the neutral zone himself. Looks to take this one all the way.
A little freelance work there by
Dylan
Trapiccio.
Haskins.
Oh, and he sends it up there.
Top shelf. Dylan Haskins on that one. Beautiful shot. Dylan, the top scorer for the Raiders. 14 goals this season so far, 7 assists.
So the net came off, and I thought that goal would be disallowed, but the officials say the goalie kicked the net off. So the goal will stand. It is Haskins assisted by Pruitt.
Well, for the record, if I was a goalie, that's exactly what I'd do every time anybody came towards my net.
Trapiccio also gets credit for the goal, or for the assist. So that's the second goal of the night for Haskins, 16 on the season. And everyone's hat is now in danger. Berkey with the puck, kicks it over to Dardine, and now Berg.
And Berg to
Corum. Corum sends it along the back wall over to Dardine.
Steve Berkey doing a nice move there. Oh, that was actually Emerson Corum taking a flip move, both his legs level with his head. Firing his Berkey right into the chest.
Both teams will swap out personnel. Raiders will send Pruitt, Haskins, and Fall back into the game. Defensemen will be Romanowski and Trapiccio. Berkey and Dardine back to the bench.
And Haskins at the faceoff in the Spartan zone.
Fall back there with the puck now. Gets it out to Pruitt. Now Haskins over to Trapiccio.
Trapiccio at the point. James Fall can't get a piece of it. Pruitt's going to get a bang. And a puck squirts out behind Dillon, and here come the Spartans. Well, the Raiders sure are all over it tonight. I tell you, there's not much wiggle room for these Spartans. Seems they have found their stride tonight.
Yeah, the Raiders look like they're on a 6-5 power play almost the whole game.
Comes James Fall, kicks it up to Pruitt. Pruitt looking to pass it back, and he does, but Trapiccio. Jake Quadi kicked one up.
Yeah, Paul, Somerset a little outmatched here with the Raiders. Really, the score at 2-0, the game has been much more of a dominating performance by the Raiders than the scoreboard shows.
Well, the board's showing almost 2-1 on shots on goal, 17 for the Raiders and 10 for the Spartans. And Berkey in the neutral zone. David Kane fires it across. And Mike Holmes doing the back check. Oh!
Yeah, shots are 17-10, but I think if you went with the time the puck is in the zone, I would say the puck has been in the Somerset zone for probably 3/4. Of the clock time. I guess we got a 3-1 ratio.
If you look closely, I believe Matt's watching Terms of Endearment on his iPad.
Kane standing in there. The Raiders up. They'll kick him out. Now Holmes stands in.
Good to see Mike back after his fractured jaw. Has not missed a beat. He kept in shape while he was healing, just skating, no hitting. But really glad that didn't keep him out longer than it did. Senior year, you don't want to miss any games.
And Holmes just leveled over there along the boards. Kind of in the camera's blind spot. They're still scrapping over there for the puck. Now it comes loose. Somerset controlling.
And A.J. all by himself.
He'll take coming it around the net.
Stephen Berkey in control, kicks it over to A.J. A.J., the lone freshman on these Hudson Raiders, making a name for himself early on.
Somerset will send the puck towards Strakota, and they'll switch out personnel.
And Taylor Casey gets it off the skate and back to himself. Oh, and Stephen Berkey upends a fella right in the middle ice.
Romanowski does the same.
Hoo! And Greg Bergson passes it up to Taylor, who just misses it. And here comes.
Looks like we've got another offsides there. Berg kind of bounced one into the Somerset zone, and the Raiders weren't in a big hurry to commit to that puck. 3:18 left in this period. Raiders leading it 2-0.
And the Raiders' first line back out. Taylor, actually Dillon Haskins at the faceoff. In the neutral zone. James Fall kicks it back to Trapiccio. Reconnoiters looking for something. Kicks it up to the boards. And Fall is pretty well smothered.
started up again from the neutral zone here.
Passes again at the faceoff.
Somerset and sends it into the Raiders zone.
Trapiccio back to Haskins. Kicks it up to James Fall, who just off his stick. A Spartan recovers, but Dillon's back on it. Back to Trapiccio. All right, here they come. James Fall through the neutral zone. Nice pass, but Dillon gets tripped up at the mid-ice. Pruitt making a run for it. Kicks it with his skate.
We're going to have a penalty on that trip there. Officials let the Raiders play through there. So that's the third penalty of the night on Somerset. Raiders have not been able to score a goal in the power play yet tonight. Both goals coming on the 5-on-5.
All right, let's see what the Raiders can do with this power play. Haskins at the faceoff. Pruitt kicks it to Haskins, who and to Trapiccio at the points. Back to Haskins. James Fall at the boards. And Pruitt's got it, looking for somebody up front. Passes it to a Spartan in a generosity move. Ooh, out in front. Pruitt fires. Oh, it dribbles past the leg of the goalie. And Trapiccio kicks it back to the boards. James Fall making his way around, looking to set something up here on this power play. Another minute 20 left. To Berkey, who trying to locate the puck, slides it across. Pruitt's on it, looking for somebody, gets it back to Trapiccio, fires one. Haskins looking to squirt it in. He's a magician that way. Oh, didn't like him in the crease, did they? Yeah, the Paul Pruitt strategy of goaltending. When in doubt, kick the net off.
Yeah,
and
Haskins
call mom.
Was going to score there. There was no doubt about that. He was just trying to work the goaltender over there.
He's quite a magician. It's amazing. You know, it seems like the puck is magnetized to his stick sometimes. I've seen a lot of times where you go, how did he get that? And Trapiccio in the neutral zone.
50 seconds left in the power play. Somerset doing a nice job on the kill tonight.
40 seconds on the power play for the Raiders. Ooh, Trapiccio sends a Spartan on his tail.
Quadi to Kane, and now Mike Holmes. Over to Trapiccio. Kicks it out to Newtonen. 20 seconds left in the power play. 1 minute left in the second period.
And the Spartans get it away.
Strakota sends it out front for Kane. Kane over to Newtonen. Newtonen gets leveled. Now both teams at full strength. 30 seconds left in the period. Trapiccio to Newtonen. Newtonen sends it to the back line. Raiders send in their first line.
Pruitt stops it. Here comes Dillon. Fires one.
Just over the crossbar. James Fall almost had an opportunity. Dravidek gets stolen there. He looked like he thought he was going to have a chance. And that will be it for the second period. So the Raiders with 9 shots on goal puts another one through the net. Somerset with 5 shots on goal in that period and unable to get another one through. So Raiders at the end of 2 lead it 2-0. Ball and I will be right back with the third period. Third period about to get underway. Chris Larson with Paul Pruitt at John Gornick Memorial Arena. The Hudson Raider hockey team playing host to Somerset, and the Raiders leading this one 2-0, about ready to get going here in the third period.
And Dylan Haskins at center ice for the faceoff. Ball gets tripped up. And here we go. Well, Spartans came out firing.
Robert Flom fires one towards Matt Strakota. And Flom with a pretty good season. 8 goals, 13 assists, 21 points for Flom on the season to enter this game. A senior for the Spartans. Raiders take control. Here's Pruitt.
Through the neutral zone he goes. Checked at the boards. And James Fall misses it on the backside. And into Hudson's territory we go.
Strakota kicks it over to Haskins.
James Fall at the boards, coming around looking for somebody out front, but no one's there.
Over to Dardine. Now to Pruitt. Pruitt leaves it for Haskins.
And, oh, Haskins looking to do the nice pass back to Pruitt, who was skating the other way. Yeah, it's neat to see Haskins and Pruitt kind of getting their forward groove on together. It's the first time they've been on the same line this season. And Mike Holmes giving him some trouble. And Trapiccio at the boards takes a
kicks it over to Kane. Kane to Mike Holmes.
Oh.
Holmes tried to lay down and block the shot there. Couldn't get there. No harm done.
Thank goodness. Even though his jaw is reinforced with steel now, I'm sure his dad is hoping he doesn't use his face as a blocking instrument again.
Well, their deductible is probably met. So.
Yeah, right. Yeah. It was either that or a UConn. Emerson Corum.
Summer sets. Jordan Langness covers up the puck. Raiders will have a face-off in the Spartan zone. Looks like Taylor Casey standing in there for the Raiders.
Oh. And the Spartans win the face-off, but the Raiders get it right back.
Berg over to Corum. Corum looking up front for Casey. Couldn't get it there. Berg steals it away, bounces it over to Corum.
Berkey fires one.
Berkey never met a shot he didn't like. Corum trying to bounce it in there, leaves it out there for Haskins, couldn't get it to go. Romanowski.
AJ through the legs of a Spartan defender. Well, Haskins just mugged a guy, robbed him, picked his pocket.
They returned the favor.
And here come the Spartans through the neutral zone into Hudson's territory. James Fall saying not tonight. And Pruitt into the neutral zone with his partner Haskins on the right. Pruitt sends it back to Haskins, who just was two steps ahead.
Fall
fired away, James.
Fired away. .14:04 left in the third period. Raiders leading it 2-0. Hudson in the white jerseys with blue trim. Somerset in the red with black trim.
Boy, Fall's been an assist machine this season. Real generous with that puck, kicking it back. I know Haskins has benefited. Pruitt's benefited. Trapiccio.
Fall leads the Raiders with 15 assists this season. Ben Lewis handling it for the Raiders. Kicks it over to Trapiccio. Trapiccio over to Quadi.
And the icing call. David Kane at the faceoff. Kicks it back to Quadi, off the boards and back to Quadi. Going to get out in front looking for something. Trapiccio on his horse.
Trapiccio
fires one
himself.
Up. Beautiful shot. Daniel Trapiccio top shelfing it over the goalie's right shoulder. Beautiful, beautiful shot.
Trapiccio with his seventh goal of the season.
With the assist, David Kane. That was pretty. Taylor Casey at the faceoff at center ice for the Raiders.
Here's Corum.
Stephen Berkey stops it in its tracks. And here come the Spartans. It's a foot race. Ooh, a big check there on Greg Berg. Upended him.
Berg takes it back. Puck hits the ceiling and we'll have a face-off in the Raiders' zone. So the Raiders have spread those goals out tonight. So far, one goal in each period. They lead it 3-0 with 12:50 left in the third period.
Got Haskins at the face-off in the Raiders' territory. Pruitt against the board sends it around. A.J. Romanowski looking to dig it out, and he does. James Fall. And here they come. Pruitt scooting across. Holds himself up. Nobody there. And back to A.J. in the neutral zone. Off the glass to a Spartan. And Berkey says, uh-uh.
Fighting it out over there in the corner. Romanowski and Haskins. Now Pruitt controls. And he loses the handle. Puck going around the back line to Berkey.
All right, Stephen Berkey making his way. Picks up Haskins' stick at center ice, who passes it up to James Fall, who brings it around the back. Still got it. Looking for somebody out in the middle.
We've got a delayed call going on. James Fall
and
sends it over to Dardine.
Pulled our goalie. The Raiders have pulled their goalie. Got another skater out.
And that'll be it. Somerset will send a man to the penalty box. See what the call is. Interference. Call goes against Jesse Anderson, senior defenseman. So the Raiders will have a power play here. It's their fourth power play of the night. They're 0-3.
David Kane at the faceoff. Firing away is Trapiccio. Vivisected the goalie right in the belly button.
Somerset will call a timeout, talk it over here. They're really in a spot where if they go down one more goal, it's pretty much good night.
So. Good night, and thanks for coming. What well, you got the stats. How's Somerset season shaping up this year?
Somerset comes into this game 10-5. They're in the middle border conference. It only has four teams. They're 2-0 in the conference, and they've got a game coming up Thursday night at Baldwin Woodville, who's 0-3. But then they play Amory, who's 2-0 in the conference. That could be a game that will decide the conference. So a couple big games coming up here for Somerset. And this may be one of those games that you just kind of come out, you play it. You know, you're playing against Hudson. It's a bigger school. You got nothing to lose.
Right.
You know, come out and do see what you can do. But, yeah, pretty good hockey team, and we certainly could see them in the postseason. They'll be in the same bracket with the Raiders when we get into the regional.
Terrific. Well, it's nice to see Hudson bounce back after their loss to Superior. Man, they wanted that one really bad, and then watched it kind of float away. Nice confidence builder to get a few ahead.
Somerset did beat New Richmond, who defeated Hudson earlier in the season, so they've got some quality wins on their schedule. Big game in the Big Rivers last week. Chippewa Falls knocked off previously unbeaten Eau Claire Memorial.
James Fall tosses it up to Pruitt, tries the hand pass to himself. Can't keep up with it. Fall with a laser stick. Dylan firing up to Pruitt. Just missed. right in front.
Here's Fall. Kicks it back to Trapiccio.
At the point. A Spartan gets a hand on it, and here they come through the neutral zone. Trapiccio to beat. And looking for that elusive goal, and Matt Strakota smothers it. Few opportunities there, Chris.
Yeah, very nice pass on the interior there. And Strakota very lucky to cover that one up. And Somerset will come away with nothing. That was Jesse Brown and company looking to get something happen. Adam Marty, the sophomore, the super soft in there as well. Marty, the sophomore, leading scorer right there, number 7 for Somerset. He took the faceoff.
And Stephen Berkey bringing it out. Kicks it up to James Fall and back to Berkey, who gets it across to Trapiccio in the neutral zone. Fires it away to Dylan Haskins. 2 on Dylan. James Fall in the back. And Trapiccio, here's Haskins got it. Pruitt's got it. Somebody wants it. And Trapiccio at the point fires to Berkey.
Pruitt controls.
Yep.
Now Trapiccio.
Full. James Fall right there.
Now Haskins. Tried to get it to Pruitt.
He's sneaky. Oh!
Puck bouncing around all over out in front of the net.
And Berkey gets it right back into the lane. Berkey's not letting anything get past that line. Trapiccio.
10 minutes left in the game.
Here comes Ben Lewis. At the neutral zone, kicks it up to Kane.
And I believe we've got an ice. So the Raiders with a 23-12 edge. In the shots on goal category. And they've got 8 seconds left in this power play.
And hoping to get a goal in the power play. 3 opportunities, like you said, tonight. This is the 4th. And it's back at full strength for Somerset.
Here's Bros.
Henry Bros fires to the boards.
Henry Bros' little brother. Shot in between periods for the Free Wings.
Oh,
nice pass out front. Couldn't get it to go. Oh, Henry Bros' little brother couldn't get it in there for the Free Wings, but we got to congratulate him. Got his first buck this season. So
oh, wow.
Big moment in a young man's life.
No doubt. Although there probably weren't as many people watching him get the buck as watched him miss the shot for some chicken wings, but he'll get more meat out of the buck.
Josh Dardine there called for the trip, and now Somerset in the power play. Reed Kelly takes the face off.
To the point for Spartans.
Drew Kelly trying to put it in there.
Manages to kick it over to the neutral, through the neutral zone and over to the Spartan zone, and they're back in. Trapiccio with a nice high stick fake.
Oh,
and they get it out of the Hudson zone. Killing time with 1:30 left in the power play. Pruitt mugs him a little in the corner. Mike Holmes looking to keep it there. A nice off the boards pass to himself.
Trapiccio with the puck now. And he'll just send it up.
That almost hit me in the mouth, Chris. Am I covered if that happens?
Looked like a frisbee.
Now watch Haskins pickpocket. He's got a magnetic stick. Oh, and here come the Spartans through the neutral zone. Trapiccio to protect. Out in front. And Stephen Berkey says, uh-uh. And Haskins kicks it around. Oh, this could be something for Ben. James Fall, I mean. And all right, let's just stop play here for a minute.
Haskins and Marty dueling it out over there on the
boards. Haskins at attention. started singing the national anthem, and everybody just stood there firing off mats that went about 40 feet straight up in the air.
That's Zach Drybidal. Drybidal's had an active evening. Comes into the game with 10 goals, 12 assists. Second in points for Somerset. Adam Marty will take the faceoff for Somerset, and it's Taylor Casey for the Raiders.
33 seconds left in the power play. Oh, and it's back into the Spartans area.
That'll burn some clock. 20 seconds left in the power play.
Here come the Spartans. Oh, off the stick. Can't quite keep up with it.
Marty's going to go up to the center. Nothing there.
To the points off the skate of number 5, Greg Berg. And Berkey launches another. Full strength for the Spartans now. Or rather for the Raiders. I'll get it straight eventually, Chris. It's just the hot chocolate talking.
We knew what you meant.
AJ.
Skating 5-on-5 out there.
All right. Looking to set it up. Taylor Casey waiting for the pass. Oh!
A little scrum over there in the corner.
And Taylor Casey right there. Wants it, and got it, and oh! And here goes 5.
Berg!
And Greg Berg right through the legs of the goalie.
Through the 5 hole for Greg Berg, and he fought for that one. He's getting pulled down as he...
With the assist from Taylor Casey.
Getting pulled down as he scored.
So, 5 hole, is that between the legs?
That is between the legs.
See, thank you very much. I thought you were correcting me.
No.
And here... Not letting up at all.
Gives the Raiders a 4-0 lead.
And Trapiccio reconnoitering the situation. Fires it up to Kane. And Kane's got it again off the boards. Wow, it's a really fast game for the third period. They are not holding back anything.
Yeah, not a lot of penalties called in this game. Nice flow to it. Whoa, Burrow's looking to get control, but he lost the puck.
And it's Spartan making his way, weaving a path. Oh, and an upended Raider. He looks like he's took the flat David on his back, knocked his breath out. David Kane.
Took a shot.
A little
shot.
Slow to get up, but he's up and at him. Oh, and Raiders falling everywhere.
And now they call a penalty.
Yeah, David Kane took the full brunt of that ice on his back. See, a fall like that, kill me, Chris. Absolutely lay me. I'd be out of work for 3 months. I may go out there and trip just to prove my point.
You've got a few more years on you. Yeah. Back when you were a strapping young man, you could have taken that several times.
I suppose. Not so much the years, it's the mileage. And the Raiders out back looking to squirt something out, and they do. Trapiccio at the point. Rifles it up to Newton. Kicks it back to Fall.
Here's Holmes.
Mike Holmes fires one off the elbow of the Spartan tender. And James Fall's got it again.
Leaves it for Newton. Newton to Fall. And the puck gets loose. 1:23 left in the power play here for the Raiders. Looking to put this game away. They lead it 4-0.
James Fall at mid ice and through into the Spartans territory. Around the back he goes. Nobody there.
Somerset switches out personnel. Raiders will set it up here.
And here they come. Greg Berg making his way through. Looking for 19 out front. Who is out front? Passes back.
Gets it to Kane, but Kane's swallowed up down there.
4 minutes left.
There's
in
Trapiccio.
This third period. And here comes Trapiccio. Look at that.
Trapiccio sends it towards the net. .340 left in the game. 15 seconds left in the power play for the Raiders.
Oh! Mid-ice, kapow. Crowd likes it. Trapiccio launches one. Strike.
Langness keeps it alive. Both teams skating 5-on-5 now. Dardine sends it ahead to Fall. And that should be an icing call, and it is. So 3:09 left in the game. I think we can safely say in the game now. I don't think we have to say third period anymore. 3:09 left in the game. We'll have a face-off in the Raiders' zone.
Well, I talked with the official. He said since I was late for the first period, we'll pay another 10 minutes at the end here just for the... Well, good night for the Raiders. They'll all be going home tonight and studying. Like you said, finals going on. I remember finals in high school. Among the most agonizing periods of my life.
It's probably the worst 10 minutes of my life.
I still have those dreams, Chris, where I think I don't have enough credits to graduate. I have to do that elusive French class. Oh, and the Raiders are keeping it up.
Ooh. Haskins looking for Pruitt out in front, and Langness just covers it up. Those are great dreams, you know, remember.
I know.
Man, I wish I was back in high school.
Yeah. It's just a...
Seemed a lot harder when you were there, though.
Right. Oh, yeah. And the hallways were much bigger.
2:25 left in this one. Raiders leading it 4-0 over Somerset.
Wow, Kane at the faceoff fires one at a shot on goal. And here come the Spartans. Oh! That's going to leave a mark. Trapiccio getting up quick.
Gets it over to Quadi. Now Trapiccio ahead to Dardine. Actually, Henry Bros. Bros takes a shot. Kick it over to Trapiccio. Trapiccio to Ben Lewis. Lewis to Kane. Trapiccio over to Quadi.
Quadi says, oh no, wow, nice hit by Quadi. Made himself a wall.
Scrapping it out over there.
Yeah, they are.
This is going to end badly.
Oh boy.
Quadi standing there going, boy, I'm hooked, but he didn't realize his arm was around the other guy's neck.
What we have here is a failure to communicate.
So with a minute and a half left in the game, things starting to break down a little bit. Raiders leading this one 4-0.
Minute 27 left. And here comes Pruitt. Through the neutral zone, kicks it up to Mike Holmes, but Mike not quite there. Spartans looking to get one on.
Romanowski breaks that one up.
Berkey in the backside. AJ.
There's Pruitt.
And Pruitt's getting on his horse. Through two defenders. Through the neutral zone, looking for, oh, and he gets pickpocketed by a Spartan.
Holmes battling it out. Berkey takes the puck away. And the whistle blows.
Well, a fine contest tonight. Well played all of for the Raiders.
Got a slash called on Drew Kelly. And I think you're just seeing some kind of some frustration setting in here for Somerset.
Yeah.
When you come into a game 10-5, you win most of your games, and you kind of just get blown out of this one. Where are
you? Oh, and that was awful pretty.
Taylor Casey, actually Trapiccio. No, it is Taylor Casey.
Yep.
Gets credit for the goal. Trapiccio sent it flying and comes right off of Casey's stick. That'll give the Raiders a 5-0 lead.
Taylor Casey.
That's Casey's third goal of the season. Trapiccio's 9th assist.
And Taylor at the faceoff at center ice with 30 seconds to go in this tonight's contest. So we may well see Somerset again, as you said.
And this one is about to become official. Casey over to Trapiccio, and there's the horn. So the Raiders with a nice win here. Coming back from that 5-1 loss to Superior on Saturday, bounce back and win it 5-0 over Somerset. And that's going to be it for the Raiders in their non-conference games this season. Their next action will be at Menominee. And then they go on the road to Eau Claire Memorial to avenge a 3-2 loss that they took as their opening conference game. And as I alluded to earlier, Memorial fell to Chippewa Falls last Thursday, which was a big one. That ties Memorial and Rice Lake at atop the conference at 5-1. It really kind of looked like Memorial may run away from the conference, but with that loss to Chippewa Falls, it really changes things. Raiders, of course, sitting alone in third place at 4-2, but Chippewa right at their heels at 4-3. So three big games coming up for the Raiders at Menominee, at Eau Claire Memorial. The next game that we will cover is January 31st, right back here at Gornick Arena. The Raiders playing host to their Highway 35 rivals, River Falls. Paul, you got anything to add to this?
Well, I'll tell you what, Chris, you're a gentleman and a scholar. It's awful fun being up here in the booth with you, getting a shot at watching from this vantage point, and definitely looking forward to our next time together. But you do great work, and I appreciate you having me here, covering for my temporary lapses of cohesion, but it's an awful good time, and you do great stuff. I hope they're paying you $400,000 a game, my friend.
I actually was able to get a little bit more than that this year.
See, well, perfect.
A little bit more, but
it's worth it. Great time.
We appreciate what you do, Paul. Thanks so much for your help, and it's been a lot of fun sitting up here with you this season. Still have at least two more games,
right?
And then if we get a home playoff game, I'm pretty sure we'll be doing that one as well. So
sounds like a plan.
Season's not over. We got more fun to come. For Paul Pruitt, I'm Chris Larson. Thanks for watching. We'll see you January 31st right back here at Gornick Arena, Hudson and River Falls.